My son Bob is the president.
And this is Emil. Emil, shake hands.
Hi. How are you?
Look here. Look at this person.
Not when there's cameras to look at.
See?
How you doing, Mr. President?
How are you?
Nice to see you again.
Good to see you.
How's it going? Good?
Pretty good. This is awful nice of you to do this.
Oh, my pleasure. Absolutely. By the way, I wanted to thank you for the letter out of the club that you sent to the 5 o'clock club. It's hanging proudly on our wall. It's now part of our crown jewels.
All right. Well, listen, I know you've been doing this, so just turn about. It's fair play.
Whoa, baby.
That is a belt buckle.
Thank you very much.
That is a gift for you.
Good to meet you.
And these, there's two girls and there's two boys. And for you girls, that's a jelly bean jar filled.
Oh,
and for the boys, that's a jelly bean so there can be no brother-sister fights.
That's fine.
Thank you for taking your time to eat.
Oh, listen. You're more than welcome.
I had this stuck in your mouth.
Okay, let's leave it alone.
Get it removed.
Yeah, put it back.
I'll wait. Oh, I will. You know, your mom said.
Last night.
That's what?
Yesterday.
I will. Your mom said to me.
I didn't know this in a minute.
No, you heard from me.
I hadn't even read the sports section this morning. I understand it was late in the game.
Oh, fire!
No, it's on their part.
Still got one next week, though, if you want to go on.
The Dallas Cowboys play better than they had all season.
Oops.
Mr. President, John has to go take on Sam Bell. John has to go pick on Sam.
These are not the jelly beans. Those are the jelly beans. If you wait patiently, I'll let you know pretty soon. Thank you for the gift.
Sir, it's nice seeing you again. Have a Merry Christmas.
Yeah, I can run interference for you.
I might just give it a shot. I think you might have to get something done.
All right.
Well, they're already camped out by the fire, right?
Yeah.
All I want to say is that, geez, one of the three of us must be unwelcome. I had to say a terrible little story for all of you.
And not while the sound's on.
Oh, yes. This is clean. It's a farmer. His wife is going away on a trip. Before she left, she said to him, "While I'm gone, can't you do something about that rickety old barn of ours that's just falling apart out there?" So right after she left, he went down the road to his friend's place named Sally and asked if he could borrow his cowherd. Sally said, "Well, yeah, but I have to warn you." He says, "When they're in a strange place, they get pretty rambunctious. They get all upset and they go tearing around." He says, "It's all right." We took him up and put him in a barn. And sure enough, they started stampeding around that barn, knocking the devil out of everything. And he went in and called the insurance company. When his wife came home, there was a brand spanking new barn out there. And she said, "How did you accomplish that?" He said, "I just wrecked the stalls with cows of Sally."
If that's on the tape, erase it. He's
much better, usually.
You're right, it isn't dirty at all.
Just terrible.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you.
How are you? Good to see you. Maybe I could do it this way. I was going to wait and go around the table later, but let me just see you. Are you wrong on this one, too?
No, not on this one.
I know everyone again in the country must be grateful to you for going there. I'm looking forward to hearing from you.
Mr. President, we are, of course, most appreciative of your time, and I'll try to be as direct and concise as possible. We took a fact-finding mission to 5 countries in Africa. And we took a total of 13 Red Cross delegates and a media contingent, 4 countries, excuse me, Ethiopia, Mauritania, Mali, and Senegal. Much of our attention was focused on Ethiopia, in as much as that seems to be the area that is most seriously affected. The purpose of our mission was very simple, to see for ourselves the nature of the need, and also to verify that that which is being rendered by the Red Cross movement is going directly to the recipients who need it. And we did assure ourselves of that. And when we will go before the American public in the next 6 weeks, asking for their assistance, we can say with certainty that it's been Red Cross to Red Cross. We saw the funds.
Ambassador Pace.
Nice to see you.
And Madame Raymond.
How do you do? Nice to see you.
Their daughter,
Edlyn. Hello. Hi. You and I will go over and have a picture in front of the fireplace, and then we will have you come in and join us. She's preaching the graduation. Once again, just our legal immigration, but mainly on the interception contract. This is not ready for that. Now, it'd be a pretty picture if you were between us. You and I will go over in front of the fireplace for a photo, and then after we have one, we exchange our papers. And well, and please send my congratulations to President Nayar. I met him in 1981 at Mexico. Meeting there and congratulating on his selection to be head of the OAU.
Thank you.
Now,
thank you, sir.
Well, welcome. Pleased to have you here. Mr. Ambassador.
Señor Presidente.
How do you do?
How are you doing?
So you and I go over.
Van a ir ahí para que saquen la foto.
Weekend in Miami. And I asked him what message he wanted me to send to you. And he said to me, to you, his congratulations for your electoral triumph. And his best wishes that you will continue. And we will continue with the friendly relations we have been having.
We share fuerte en favor
del proceso que él ha. You are bearing great support in favor of the process that he has undertaken.
Well, we shall continue that support.
Vamos a continuar ese respaldo, ese apoyo.
We're very pleased with the advance of democracy.
Muy agradecido por el avance que ha tenido lugar en cuanto a la democracia.
Welcome.
Bienvenido.
Republic of Yemen?
Yes, Mr. Ambassador, President. I'm not.
And Mrs. Alaini?
How do you do? President. Nice to see you.
Their sons?
Mr. President.
And Tarek. Hello.
How do you do?
Fine, thank you.
You and I will go over in front of the fireplace for a photo, and then you will come in and join us for a group picture. Right? Let's just exchange our papers. Well, thank you. And this is your second time? Well, we look forward to increasing the relationship with you. If you're between us, it's a nicer picture.
It's an honor, Mr. President.
Well, honored to have you here.
And Madame Khan.
How do you do?
And
my daughter.
Suman. And son, Riyadh.
Yes. How do you do?
And daughter-in-law,
Chita. How do you do? Well, so, you and I will go over and have a picture taken in front of the fireplace, and then you will all join us.
Ambassador of the State of Bahrain.
Yes. Mr. Ambassador, welcome. Pleased to have you. Mr.
Delacroix.
Yes.
President. And Mr. Dyson.
Yes, Mr. President. Let us go over here for a photo. Whoops. I'm sorry. My appreciation also for our country for your hospitality to our units there in the Gulf. We are most appreciative. We look forward to further military discussions with you. All right. Yeah. Welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.
President, the Ambassador of Egypt.
Yes, Mr. Ambassador, welcome. We're pleased to have you here.
Very much.
And Mrs. El Reedy.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
And daughter Nada.
How do you do?
And Selma.
Hello there. Nice to see you. You and I will go over in front of the fireplace for a photo, and then you ladies will join us. Okay. And please convey my regards. President Mubarak, and my hope that in March you will be able to come here for a working visit.
Thank you very much.
Send for an interpreter because Air Force has talked here.
Well, I don't have much experience. I'll be in the plane.
All right.
Ready?
See you, sir.
Come on in, take a chair. Maybe sends her love to you.
Oh, well, I was to her.
She's, I know she's getting better. She wants to spend New Year's back here. I think the real reason is she wants to go to the inauguration. And I told her, we'll go down and watch you sworn in, but no dancing. That gets to be old.
Back left. month.
Remember the killer tree. Can you give us a moment, Mr. President? Can you let us talk to you a moment, sir? Can you give us a moment up here?
No, because I'm late, not only late here, but now I'm even more late for my next appointment. So I've got to go in there.
But South Africa.
No, it's a sugar maple.
South Africa's arrested two people who were in the British Embassy, and there's a report that we had sort of told them that they would not be arrested if they left.
You're giving me a news bulletin here. That hasn't been brought to my attention yet, so I've got it to say.
Okay. Baker, where have you been?
Now you ask me why I took my time coming home.
I should have thought better.
Thanks for coming.
Hey, Phil, how's your lip reading? We didn't see his lips.
Well, Mr. President, how are you doing?
Good.
Good to see you again. Thank you. Thank you for seeing me.
Well,
it was a nice party last night. I chatted with you. You left too soon. Listen, you left before we started the boogaloo and all the good dancing in there.
Oh,
that's why you left. You know what you were
I have a party. You come down and make an appearance, but then you don't want to put it be a damper on it. Is that what you're saying? Yeah, you were going to be a damper. You should have seen Bob Mike.
Every time we stopped dancing,
he started shaking.
A receiving line.
Oh, yeah. Well, they did that. I very much appreciate you giving me this little opportunity to come express.